Hi. I have a confession. Ever since I was really little, I love to read about disasters, exactly like the one that we're living right now. So, from the time I was really little, I just loved to read books where there was a nuclear war, or there was a plague, or where there was some other kind of disaster that forced everybody to imagine a whole new society. Like if everything went into complete upheaval and a lot of people died, and then the book would be, or the story would be, whatever happened after that disaster. These are part of a group of stories called utopian fiction. I have a little stack, short stack of some of the books that I like to read and reread and reread because I find them weirdly comforting. But one of these is Thomas More's Utopia, and this is kind of the granddaddy of all the utopias, where he imagines a society that is perfect. There's an island and everything is set up to be exactly the way it should be. So for this week's class, what I'm going to be doing is talking about the utopian tradition in British literature. And we'll be talking specifically about George Orwell's super famous 1984. You're probably already familiar with a lot of utopian or dystopian stories. I've already talked about Sir Thomas More's Utopia and how some utopian fictions talk about a perfect world. When one of these stories describes a horrible world, like The Handmaid's Tale, critics use the term dystopia to talk about this kind of story. But whether we use the term utopia or dystopia, most of the time, what this kind of literature or this kind of storytelling is doing is showing us another version of the world that we actually already live in. Sometimes a utopian story will pretend to take place on an island or in some faraway land, like Thomas More's Utopia or Jonathan Swift's Gulliver's Travels. Sometimes these stories take place in the faraway past or the distant future, as with the original Planet of the Apes movie. Sometimes the new world we imagine comes about because of a natural disaster. Often, these disasters are man-made, like wars or environmental disasters, and critics talk about this as post-apocalyptic fiction. One especially famous example of post-apocalyptic fiction is the original Planet of the Apes story.
Thank you.
recently, Hayao Miyazaki's Nausicaa of the Valley of the Wind depicts a future society that has been impacted by an apocalypse. Some science fiction stories imagine a combination of disasters, both war and pandemic. Other narratives ground their entire utopian vision on the foundation of a plague or disastrous pandemic. This includes Stephen King's The Stand and the recent series of the Planet of the Apes movies. There are countless stories like this in British literature. In addition to Sir Thomas More's Utopia, we have Daniel Defoe's Robinson Crusoe, Jonathan Swift's Gulliver's Travels, Samuel Butler's Erewhon, William Morris's News from Nowhere, Sir Francis Galton's Can't Say Where, Aldous Huxley's Brave New World, of course George Orwell's 1984, and Anthony Burgess's The Wanting Seed. Now that you've got an overall idea of what utopian fiction is, please join me for an episode of Close Reading. I'll read and analyze a short section from Chapter 5 of George Orwell's 1984. This closer look at 1984 will give you a better idea of the kinds of concerns and narrative features common to this genre.